Hey, buddy, it's Invicta. It is time for another Eden run, except today, by request, we are doing another greedier run. It's been a little bit since we've done one, and the Mosh Pit was asking for one. I don't know why, but we are going to do one today. So happy Sunday, everybody. I know it's not a random run today, but it, I mean, it's kind of random because obviously it's Eden. You know, you all know what the score is by now. But yeah, got to get ready for a greedier run. Obviously, this is going to be a lot more difficult than our regular runs. Well, usually anyway, depending on our Eden start. But first, here's your meme of the day. Actually, first off, we did get another like streak tally down below. Thank you all very much for making it possible. Hey, look at that. We got an actual streak going on. Let's keep it going by clicking that like button, getting this over 3,000, yada, yada, yada. Now 98 over 120. Thank you very much, Mosh Pit. Hope your weekends are going great. And this time we have a very first time submitter here for this type of meme here, brought to you by Heraidric. Title throws, we got ourselves a bingo, everyone. This is the card from episode 700 of the Repentance series. Congratulations, Heraidric. I do like the fact that like people go back retroactively and fill out the bingo cards and like sort of like dab them. I do like the little bingo, like dabber little marks there. Thank you very much, Heraidric. This actually made me laugh a whole lot. And please start giving me more of the bingo cards. I'd love to see what episodes are more successful than others on that. That is just so good. So thank you very much. Here we go. I don't know how long this episode is going to be, but it could be long. It could be short. We'll figure it out. CJ is going to be 8 kilo 3 Foxtrot. Ha! Yep. We got Roid Rage here. We've got great damage. And thanks to, I guess it's consolation prizes giving us the great damage here. We're also going to start off with the Intruder. We also have Undefined, although Undefined's kind of not great for greedier. We also have a Demon Judgment here. I would love to get Synthoil. Synthoil will be a huge, huge start here. So let's see if we can make that happen. But yeah, at least one solid good item, and then another one, which, you know, the Intruder is okay. Having that multiple Spider Bite shot is pretty nice for crowd control. There's no danger associated with it, and it just makes Isaac's fake face look, you know, horrible. But other than that, it's, you know, kind of there. It is the worst face by far. I mean, for a long time running, it was always the dead dove face, but, like, the Intruder face is actually god-awful. Like, actually god-awful. Oh, and piggybacking off of the spider story the other day, because some people didn't like that fact that I killed a spider. I did a good deed today, actually. So I have a spider problem in my house. Like, they're usually not big spiders. They're usually like little brown spiders, like little, I don't think they're brown recluses. At least I hope not anyway. Anyway, usually if I see them like in the corners and like the nooks and crannies, like I keep my house really clean, but like they still somehow, they love to make webs in the little corners along like the molding and the footboards and stuff. So what I do is when I vacuum, I regularly, like, you know, see them, I'll just vacuum them up and then, like, you know, throw them outside or whatever. Well, this one in particular, I found it was in a corner that I've never seen a spider before. And it was a little brown spider, like always, except this one was a little bit more little than usual. And when I turned on the vacuum and I started coming towards it, it kind of scampered up its little corner cobweb and went into the corner and like pressed itself like super flat. I've never seen a spider get this flat against the corner. And it was clearly like terrified and stuff. And I was sitting there trying to like vacuum it up so I could like, you know, kick it outside or whatever. But I couldn't get it. Like, I was sitting there like kind of poking and prodding it with the corner of the vacuum, and it just was not. Oh my God. What kind of run is this, man? We just got Steam Sale, pretty much the best item you can get in greedier. Yeah. Gonna go ahead and take that as well. We get Eucor Mycosis as well as the Synthoil. So anyway, yeah, so like I was trying to poke and prod the spider and just trying to get it out of there, and I wanted to, like, you know, remove it. I'd already gotten the web, I'd already gotten like the little, like, it sucked up a little bug that was on there, and but like I could not reach it. Like, it was doing like a phenomenal job at staying really flat. Anyway, long story short, I ended up feeling bad for the spider because, like, it was clearly terrified. And I was like, you know what? I don't usually do this, but little spider, you've won my heart. You've won me over. And I just let it go. I just let it sit in the corner. And so I checked on it later on today, and it had already started rebuilding its own, like, the web and everything. Like, this was hours ago. So I guess I now have a spider that's just chill in my house now. You know, and I told Mom Evicta this, and she was like, well, I didn't actually mean to pick that up, but we got it. I told Mom Evicta this, and she was like, well, you know, little spiders turn into big spiders. Like, yeah, I know. And if it gets too big, then you know what? We'll have to do something about it. But for now, I'm cool with the little spider being here. We get D Bizzle. Oh my goodness. I don't think I've ever seen such a hot start to a run here. I'm going to pass on all the other items for now just because we have 7 cents. We have more than 7 cents. I hope this doesn't take us to the curse room. So let's find out where Undefined goes. We go to the item room. That's fine. I don't know if there's IMR rooms in Greedier, but I guess we're going to find out. So I just wanted to tell that story because, you know, I did feel bad for this little spider. I mean, it was like curled up and flat. I mean, it did look terrified, as terrified as a tiny little spider can be. And I was like, you know what, buddy, you all right. We can be pals. We can be roommates. I'm not going to charge you rent. All I require you to do, brown nuggets actually like fantastic for Greedier. This is an insane start, man. But yeah, you know, like, I'm not going to charge him rent or anything. I just need him to take care of the stray mosquitoes that find their way in here every now and then. We'll be all right. This is a crazy, crazy good start here for Greedy. I don't think I've ever seen a hotter start than this, especially for an Eden like start. We started out with great tiers, great damage, great everything, and we're getting hooked up. Now, I don't think D Bizzle's actually all that great for Greedier, just because obviously we're not going to be finding any like random hearts anywhere. But if we end up finding more like lover's cards or, you know, stuff like that, basically lover's cards, or maybe like, I don't know, we might find an ace of hearts. You never know. Don't judge me. But yeah, the brown nuggets actually fantastic because we get to make ourselves little turrets everywhere, and that's, you know, it's not that they don't. We could actually sit here and just farm this if we wanted to. Not farm it, but like just make unlimited blue flies. But, you know, they don't deal negligible damage. What is this? What kind of boss encounter is that, game? That boss encounter is designed to make you lose instantly if you're not paying attention. Ecor Mycosa is doing a good job. Look at the intruder getting itself a proper hit there. Now, we need to be careful here. I'm hoping that the all of our blue flies don't like mask too many shots here. You just saw right there that shot almost hit us. Check out the devil deal. We cannot take the Satanic Bible. And I don't think that taking Abyss is smart. As much as I would love to get the Satanic Bible, we just can't right now. Okay, so let us, I do want to go in the curse room because we might be able to get back in there if we get an HP upgrade, which, I mean, I guess technically we could just buy a soul heart. Let's see if we can teleport our way back into the devil deal, and we cannot. Oh, no. Yeah. Two hearts. Doubles the amount of hearts that we can recover. That's pretty good. I don't really want BFF. Our battery would be amazing with the Satanic Bible. Unfortunately, we don't have it. We do get the sprinkler, though. I honestly think the brown nugget might be better than the sprinkler, as sad as that might be for now. But we're really going to be looking for, like, the Book of Revelations at this point. Anything that can give us HP here. And Montezuma's... You all know I love Montezuma's Revenge, but in this spot, I don't know. Void is not bad either. I'm going to buy Booster Pack just to see if we can get a Two of Diamonds. Get Two of Clubs. Got Joe Free card. We get a Judgment card. Hierophant's good. Okay. The Judgment will allow us to re-roll stuff. I would love to get Squeezy if we can make it happen. That'd be great. And we are going to be able to do it. So thank goodness for that fortune-telling machine. Oh, and there's Binky, too. That's such a great tiers up, too. I think a judgment card would be good because that would spawn two rerollable pedestals. I don't have a full charge for undefined, unfortunately. We could try to find the secret room. Get a key here that could also be kind of pog. Gonna risk it for the biscuit here and go after this golden chest and maybe get some upgrades. Okay. Thank you, game. Okay, so... But, we're still massively ahead here. We got car battery. We got judgment. Get out of jail, car. Open anything? No, it didn't. Two hearts, might as well recover our hearts. We'll take the judgment card just to give us a reroll pedestal when we need it. I'm going to check for the secret room. We know that it can't be adjacent to the shop because we literally were just there. It can only be here, really. I don't remember if the rocks are there. Okay. All right, but that was a good floor, though. We just need some money. Okay. Sty, I'm not going to pass up Sty. Our tears rate is high enough to where... I mean, our tears rate's not, like, incredible, but it's okay. Basically a free bomb here, and we can check for the secret room, and there is one here. Oh, baby. Oh, man, I thought that was going to be the counterfeit. The counterfeit penny is absolutely top tier in Greedier. That's a disappointment. It's Stitches. I mean, well, actually, Stitches can get us into the curse room for free, at least. Thank you, D-Bizzle. Appreciate it, bro. Appreciate it. Should have expected that. What? Am I going crazy, or were we... Oh, whatever. Anyway. Deep pocket. Or torn pocket. I'm gonna go open this other chest here. And it was not worth it. Alright. D-Bizzle with a justice card. There we go, D-Bizzle. Look at that. Alright. We got back some of our money anyway, so... Thank you, D-Biz. Oh, you know why? It's because we have car battery. That's why we were teleporting twice. Excuse me. But now we're going to be making two blue pooters every single time we use brown nugget, and I kind of love that. No problem at all. Let's get some pooter coverage over here. The counterfeit penny would have been absolutely mint if we could have gotten it. I think that's what the Aussies say. They call stuff mint. Look at our pooter army going to town here. Now, you might be looking at this and thinking like, oh, wow, like, you're totally fine in this run. Like, it's not even going to be difficult. Well... The thing is that Ultra Greedier is a whole different can of worms. It's not like we're sitting here just dominating the game with stats. Like we're getting good items, don't get me wrong. But this is not a face roll like opportunity here. This is not a we can do this on with blindfolds on situation. We're still very much at the mercy of our stats and our tier effects, which right now, like, yes, our stats are okay, but they're not, like, we don't have to worry about Ultra Greedier okay. Here's our devil deal here. Here. And, yep. Now, could I have re-rolled that with the judgment? Yes, of course I could have. Do I want to? No. Because this is the reason why right here is because we can very easily just get something better for us. I don't think we want torn pockets, or do we? Wait. Taking damage, okay. Yeah, so taking damage can cause us to basically generate other things other than keys and money and stuff. I would have looked to see what's over here. I'm not gonna try to lie to you. Use bombs here to see. We get, oh, huge growth. Okay. We've already been in the curse room. You know, we can go in there and open up that golden chest. We have that extra soul heart. So, and that was absolutely, positively not worth it. Good run, though, so far. It's looking promising. All right. Did get magic mush, of course, which is a huge help. Tropicamide, which is debatably a huge help, but you know. Oh man, we get birthright for Eden. We can't actually afford right now, but just a hoping. You D-Bizzle. D-Bizzle being an absolute lord right now. Need to get away. It's a stone hand, okay. I say, if it's a stone hand, we don't want it to do the fissure near the reroll pedestal because it will reroll. And that's no bueno. That is decidedly unbueno. But here, if we do take damage with torn pockets, at least we'll be able to have a chance of getting other things, which would in turn maybe save us some money in the long run, even though we lose money at the start when we like take damage and stuff. This is me speaking with an upward inflection to seem like I know what I'm talking about, but really, it's what all YouTubers do. I didn't even see, like, I swear to you, I didn't even see that Diglett there. So with the right amount of coverage here with our blue flies, we will have just enough DPS to pretty much take down all mini bosses without really too much issue. I'm trying to localize them more towards the center so I can, if I have to kite them away, like I can at least put them in an easily reachable spot. Yeah, they're just gunning everything down here. Need to be careful because they will make war kind of jostle a bit. We don't want them to be jostled right into our path here. I didn't even see those shots there. We got three bosses, by the way. We got Champion War and then Red Champion Monstro 2 along with Super Wrath. How did that happen, game? Oh, you done goofed, Monstro. You went right into the fly's nest. Not a hornet nest, it's a fly nest. Okay, well, I'm just going to be fighting Monstro again. Gonna make it very impossible to see which shots are ours and which shots are not, but you just only assume. The sad thing is that, like, Monstro 2 is so fast that I can't really enjoy seeing the HP bars go down when they run into the fly web here. But we did get a nickel there, so that actually worked out for us okay. With the torn pockets, and we get 9 lives and sulfur. Sulfur is a damage up, and we get Mega Brim. But it's just not as fun as just seeing a bunch of booters firing at stuff. So the correct play there, the correct play is absolutely Sulfur. D-Twanky does not work in Greedier, unfortunately. It's not like it used to anyway. Yeah, that's all I'm gonna take. Let's buy a couple of soul hearts just to kind of top us off here before we go to the next floor. We shall head on to the zone. And yes, I should have rerolled the W. Here's the unknown. His juice is excellent. More damage for us. Gotta buy ourselves a Yave now. And Tough Love, we have negative luck, so Tough Love's not really going to do anything. Trying to stay on top of the micro with Brown Nugget. Shout out to Brown Nugget, like, seriously, like, this is not a usual item that you see me use all the time, but man. That's why I was like, you know, I was thinking about it when I saw it drop, and I was like, you know, that's a pretty good item. Brown Nugget is not to be trifled with in Greedier. I can't tell if that's thunder or if that's the game. I keep hearing a rumbling outside. Not sure what that is. Might be an airplane. I mean, we just absolutely smoked this wave without doing anything, basically. Yeah, the pooters are... Oh my god. Again, I think Sulfur was the right call, but now I don't know. Maybe sticking... I wanted to stick with Brown Nugget just because it's just more fun. But man, this is actually pretty gnarly here. Got, of course, Holy Shot. Oh, Double Conquest. Holy Shot from the shop is pretty good as well. Especially with our tears rate. Yeah, we are just smoking them. The Mark and Guppy's Hairball. Mark is going to give us movement speed and, more importantly, damage. This is a pretty god-awful store, so I'm just going to... Oh, I'll save the bomb. Not going to go in the curse room. I think that that's a little bit of a foolish folly. Here we are. We're already at the final shop here. D1 Hizzle. I don't think we want the D1 Hizzle. I'm going to save a lot of this for HP, but more importantly, for the Devil Deal. Let's buy breakfast. We don't actually need Wire Cone Hanger, surprisingly. Before we do anything else, let's fight the... Whoops, I didn't mean to do that. Let's fight the boss. Let's fight the room here. Because the plan is going to be we're using the Judgment card... The reverse judgment card inside of the Devil Deal. Got a golden key. We're also okay. I don't know what is hitting us. I lost myself in this dish mash. All right, we got a cardio coin thanks to Corn Pockets. I haven't even had a chance to use the Brown Nugget yet. Now, putting these dang spikes in here is pretty troll. Luckily, we were able to kill the wave before they were. Allowed to persist. I say that I definitely think that Torn Pocket has helped us more than it's hurt us. Especially with that cardio coin, it's pretty important. We get bloat. Really tough to see where I am without having a head. Sticky nickel, unfortunately. This is hectic with all these pooters and me not having a head. This is very difficult to see where Isaac is. Okay. Do not have a bomb, unfortunately. Got 40 cents though. Okay, Spear of the Night and Pogatory. I don't think we want either of these, so I am going to finally use our Judgment card in here and start re-rolling. Ooh, boy. Little Horn is good. With this tears rate, I think Little Horn is a go. We don't need Spectral Tears anymore. We're already capped on tears, and we just don't need it. We could get Guppy if we get one more Guppy item. Damocles does nothing for us, unfortunately. Oh, come on. Okay. We need to start thinking about HP preservation here. We could just go hard for Guppy, but then we got to fight Ultra Greedier with no shielding at all and 1 HP. I don't know, man. I have to stop. Gotta do it. I actually didn't even know that cardio coin was still here. That's pretty much what we want here. Diamonds doesn't really help us anymore. I think we just load up and go with this. I know that rerolled a nickel, but we have no way of getting it anyway. So I'm just trying to shore up our defenses here. Because, yeah, Ultra Greedier is no slouch. All right, so we're going to drop the pooters here just to help us out with greed. This doesn't really matter. Remember, there's no cooldown on Brown Nugget. It's just kind of a slow recharge, so. All right, here we go. There's no excuses. We should have this done. Don't really need to drop. It would be better for us to drop Torn Pocket because we don't want to drop two coins because Ultra Greed actually heals off of that, so we don't want to do that. We're just gonna make a wasteland of blue flies in the middle here. Also, don't know what was hitting me at the very start. It was like his hitbox was like extended. It's very weird. Obviously, this is only phase one of greed. True form of greed has not arrived. We're pretty far away from that. I don't want to concentrate the pooters too much in one area because I do kind of want to spread them out a little bit because Ultra Greedier is going to be moving around a whole lot. Let's get some more coverage down here. Try to take down some of the doors. Now, the longer we actually win the long game here, which is unusual during a greed fight because usually greed. The longer you're in a fight, the chances are better for the boss. But because of the way that Brown Nugget is working for us here with Car Battery, that leads to our advantage. So as long as we can outlast Greed, we're going to make his life a living hell. He's just going to be peppered by the blue flies here nonstop. Give him the pepper. Taking a little bit more damage than I like. Nun's Habit would have been great. Need to make sure we're using the blue nut, or the brown nugget on every cooldown. It might be in our best interest to wait for a couple more charges here, just so we can get more of the blue flies out. Go. Got a couple extra charges, and now the real fun begins. I think the thing I hate about Ultra Greed is that you can't see when he fires if his back is to you. You see him kind of jerk a little bit, and then all of a sudden there's just a multi-shot headed straight toward you. Not to be too concerned with the bombs. Wherever you go, Greed, our fly army will be there. There we go. Down goes Ultra Greedier. Oh boy. It's always stressful, man. It's always super stressful, but we did get the dub. Thank you everyone for all the requests. I do appreciate it. And thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. Whew, I'll take that on a Sunday. Nice, easy, relaxing Sunday. So if you enjoyed this video, like I said, make sure you click that like button. If you're not already subscribed here, please consider subscribing if you'd like daily Isaac content and more. And thank you, everyone, for being a part of the Mosh Pit. I hope you have a great start to your new week here. As always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank the patrons of mine like Alyssa, Fred, and Bataloid. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find down below, or by going to patreon.com/Sinvicta.